Hey guys, my name is David Myhall, and I just wanted to make a video sharing the project that I've been working on for the past couple months. It's a project that some of you might have already used without even knowing. It's what I'm calling the Burner Wallet 2. It's a burner wallet based on Austin Griffith's original burner wallet. This wallet's been used for events in ETH Berlin and ETH Boston, and it's gonna be used at DevCon and ETH Waterloo coming up too. So if you're at one of those events and you used it, you might have just thought it was Austin Griffith's original burner wallet that he used at ETHDenver and a number of other events. And that's intentional. The design is basically copied right from his wallet. But what I wanted to do with this project was to take Austin's original idea and original vision and restructure the code base in a way that anybody could take it, restructure it, build their own wallet, and add their own features to it. What this wallet really is a collection of different libraries. You can import the different modules that you want, combine them together in one simple JavaScript file, and build it and create a new burner wallet, easy as that. The modules are things such as assets. You can import DAI, XDAI, ETH to use as your currencies, or you can import the ERC20 class and define another currency. Some of the modules define technical features, such as the gateway you use to access the network. You have a choice between connecting with Infura, connecting with Rivet, or using the browser's built-in Web3 provider if it's available. And what I think is the coolest feature is the ability to add different plugins. The Burner Wallet 2 has a really robust plugin architecture. You can add buttons to the home screen, you can add pages, you can add actions that occur when a QR code is scanned. You can even define new interfaces for exchanging between different assets. By default, the wallet has support to use Uniswap to convert between tokens. It also supports the XDAI to DAI bridge, but if you wanted to support a different way of converting, you can build features for that too. We've used this plugin in a few really cool different ways. At ETH Boston, we did a burner wallet happy hour. Just like all the happy hours, Austin's already done. You walk into a bar, you get a paper wallet, scan it on your phone, and you can buy beer with it. But at this event, we built a menu plugin. So instead of having to scan someone else's QR code to order a beer, you can order it right in the app, like it's Uber Eats or something. I think there's tons of possibilities for people to build their own plugins and add really exciting new functionality to this wallet. I've already worked with a number of developers that are building really cool plugins that'll be out soon. So if you're interested in throwing together a burner wallet, whether it's at a project at a hackathon or just to test out some cool idea, check out the code base. And if you just want to run a simple burner wallet at an event or something, check out burnerfactory.com. This is a project that lets you spin up a burner wallet really quickly. We're going to be adding a ton more features to both the wallet and the factory, and I'll talk about those soon. But if you've got any questions, feel free to shoot me a message at dmihal, that's D-M-I-H-A-L, on Twitter or Telegram. And if you're heading out to DevCon, make sure you stop by the Maker booth there. They're gonna be running a special version of the Burner Wallet 2 and using it to give away some really cool goodies. So check that out.